Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is George coming at you with another video. And today I have gone out and explored the world. Yes, I have explored the world outside of Cisco certifications, something I didn't actually anticipate I'd ever do. So let me talk to you guys a little bit about that. So as you guys know, the world is moving to the cloud, particularly in the data center. It's been a very, very quick movement from on-premise data centers to enterprise networks, moving that data center from there out to the cloud. So of course, not every workload is being moved out to the cloud, at least in most organizations, but at least some, or actually some very, very large enterprises are moving some, if not everything, out to the cloud, whether that be through AWS or Azure or GCP. So I've been working quite a bit on data center technologies lately. A lot of opportunities that have come my way have been around data center. And of course, a lot of what we talk about day to day is this movement to the cloud. And I thought, you know, if I'm really going to be talking about this stuff, I need to at the very least learn one of the major cloud providers. And for me, that's AWS. AWS is the industry leader in cloud technologies. And I thought I'd go ahead and take a look at some of the training for that. So oftentimes when I go into a new technology, I look for training. And for me, I think hands down the best training, and I haven't been through all of the different training sites, but I can say that acloudguru, that's acloud.guru, the website, is a great resource for pretty much anything cloud or Linux. It's been really, really awesome. And so what I did is I went ahead and got a subscription. I got I believe it was a 7 or 14 day free trial, and it's just $29.99 a month after that. And I decided to take the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner certification course. I went through all of that. They have really great content that they update. It seems like they really keep their stuff up to date. I noticed that when I was going through some of the course, there were a few videos that they had just re-uploaded a day or two ago with, I guess, some of the feedback that they get from the community as to what things that are missing and what things need to be changed based on what they're seeing in the certification test. So it goes through the entire course, all of the subjects that you need to learn. Then at the end of each section, there's a quiz. And at the end of the entire thing is pretty much a mega quiz and a practice simulator. After going through all of that, it didn't take me very long at all, probably about 3 weeks or so to go through all the content, to go through all the tests and go through pretty much just all my notes and just make sure that I was ready to go in and take the test. So this past Friday, I decided to go and sit the test. It cost me about $100 to go in. Decided to go in 10:30 in the morning, nice and fresh, went into the test, and I'm happy to say that the content was so good, it really did prepare me for what I was gonna expect for this test. And I walked out of there knowing that I had passed. So now I am officially AWS certified, specifically the AWS Cloud, Certified Cloud Practitioner. Still trying to get the acronyms right on this AWS stuff. So needless to say, I am very excited about that, getting another certification under my belt outside of Cisco, but still within technology. I am excited to move forward to the AWS Solutions Architect Associate exam, which I have already started. From what I hear, you already have about 60% of the knowledge with the CCP certification. So moving forward, it's only the next 40%. And so far, I am seeing that that is the case, at least moving through S3 and EC2 services. It seems like a lot of the same stuff is there. So that's pretty much the update for me. If you guys are interested in AWS certifications, I would highly recommend you guys check out acloud.guru. They have a great certification program. And by the way, every time you pass a certification, they let you update it in your profile. And it's pretty much just a way to show that you have been able to accomplish the certification. When you receive the certification from Amazon, by the way, they give you actually a discount for the next test that you go take. So I forgot exactly how much it is, but I was actually surprised to see that they actually give you discount for the next test that you take, either to recertify or to take another certification test. And they also give you some free practice tests for whatever test that you want to take next, which I just thought was pretty great. It was a pretty great resource for me. So again, just thank you guys for watching this video. And if you guys have any questions about AWS certifications, whether or not you guys should do it, whether they're worth it, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Subscribe, hit that bell icon if you haven't already, and want to receive content like this in your feed, I would greatly appreciate it. Thank you guys for watching this video, and take care.